Hi guys, Morgan here from Paul's Fishing Systems. This morning we're trying out the SwellPro Spry drone. These drones and the remotes are waterproof and they're really easy to use. Now these drones are a lot smaller than the Splash Drone 4 and FD1 drones, so their payload is quite a bit less than the Condor and FD1 and SD4 drones. These are recommended for 2 or 3 hooks. So to turn it on, you press and hold the power button on the remote, same on the drone. Once you've done that, the remote will say initializing. That's just meaning that it's communicating between the drone and the remote. Once you've done that, then you're going to be calibrating it. To calibrate it, you just toggle the right hand switch up and down until the screen says to calibrate. Now at this point, all you have to do is read the display on the remote. It's actually telling you what to do. So it's rotating clockwise on the horizontal plane. Once you've done that enough, it'll say to do it vertically with the nose down. So that's what Jamie's doing here. Vertical calibration, clockwise, nose down. Now the remote's just saying initializing again, so that's just inputting that data and then you'll be ready to fly. So the Spry drones have a tension release. They come with the SwellPro Troll Safe clip. Now one thing we did find with these drones is that they do sit very low to the ground, so you have to be careful that the release clip doesn't actually get any sand or grit in it, which happened to us this day, so we had to clean it out a few times before we actually managed to get it to fly and keep the line in. Being so low to the ground helps their stability when they're landing, so it's worth just keeping in mind that you will have to clean that release mechanism out, place to have a bottle of water or something on you just to rinse it out if you need to. Now Jamie's going to show us how to start the drone.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is start her up by pushing it inwards like that. And if you want to see that, push it.
So left lever is your up and down and side to side, right lever is forwards and backwards as well as turning the drone.
Yep, good to go, bro.
Now this day we're actually using the performance props on the Spry. They come with two blade props. We've got our three blade props on. They give you a bit extra lift, but they do drain the battery a bit faster, so you have to be mindful of that if you're using these props. So you would have seen there, to return it home you just flick the return to home switch top left of the remote there. To set the hooks, all you have to do is flick your bail arm over. Tension comes on, hooks drop out of the release clip. Easy as that. When it's returning home, it does everything automatically. We're not doing anything special here, just letting it land itself. So these drones come standard with a 4K camera that can record 30 frames per second. So pretty good little camera on these. They don't have any gimbal on them, so you do have to be mindful of that when you're flying it. If you want to get a stable shot, you do have to be very smooth on your controls. There we go, landed. Turns itself off, you don't have to do anything else there. As you've probably seen in our other videos, we like to test the waterproofness of these drones. So here we're going to take it up, take it for a swim, and just make sure that it does what it says on the box. Well, that doesn't seem to be causing it any strife. So we'll have a look from the drone's perspective. Unfortunately, we don't have any SD card in the drone, so we'll just have to see it on the remote. So that all went well, so now we're just going to throw it in and see if it takes off from water from not being going to start with. So here we go. So no issues there. Now let's see that again from the drone's perspective.
That's the one though.
Joshua joined us for the morning, being school holidays. His first time drone fishing, and he gets to wind in a couple of little snapper. The snapper's about 35 centimeters, caught on the target snapper hooks. All of our drone rigs come with target snapper hooks. You'll see the little wire appendage on the back there. These hooks are scientifically proven to catch more legal size, less undersized snapper. Now, inline swivel clips with the swivel belt onto the clip reduce tangles. These come standard on all of our rigs. That snapper was nice and happy when we brought him in, so we thought we'd let him go home again. There he goes. Now Joshua's bringing in our second line, and we only set two lines this day. Just wanted to do a quick trip before work. It was sort of our first real time playing around with the Spry drone. So there is something fighting on the end of this line. Feels like another little snapper, but we'll see. So we've just stopped winding. We're gonna let this paddleboarder pass. We don't want him to get tangled up in our line. You'll see Jamie over there still playing around in the water with the Spry drone. Pretty awesome little drone. So hopefully we'll be doing demos with these ones soon. So subscribe to our newsletter and you'll get to come along and see these for yourself and have a play with one for yourself if you're game enough. As an all-round filming and fishing drone, they're a pretty good idea. Just bear in mind that they don't have a huge payload, so really only designed for running two or three hooks. to a maximum of 800 metres. Yep, so another little snapper. This one was about 31, 32 centimeters, so still legal, but not really big enough for a meal, so we'll put this one back too. Again, lip hooked on the target snapper hooks. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel to see more videos. We get out all over the place with all different types of drones, so stay tuned.